Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to be doing a little experiment here with some of the silverware. And this stuff has a sterling silver handle on it, and then the utensil part is actually stainless. And so you can see from, you know, some of these handles that have been knocked off, this is the silver part. And we're going to knock all the handles off the silverware and try and melt them down in our furnace and get a sterling silver block out of it. All right, so I'm going to try and knock the sterling silver part of this knife off. It starts right here. I'm just going to take it on my table here, hit it with a hammer, and the sterling silver split up there pretty easy. And it's full of a bunch of putty junk, so I'll have to mix a little bit of flux in there. But you can see there's the silver part here, and here's the stainless steel part of the knife that we can just take to the scrapyard. We're really interested in this for the value. All right, so here's the silver handles from our silverware, and here's all the stainless steel junk that we don't want. Okay, here's our crucible. I ended up bashing up the handles a little bit so they'd all fit in there, and we got 12 handles total. So I'm going to take my crucible, put them in our KO wool furnace here. This is just a couple wraps of KO wool on top of some fire brick. So I'll take the crucible here, put it right in there. There's a lid behind it, and we'll put a propane burner right through there, and we'll get it up to temperature, get it all molten. I'm going to put probably about 100 to 150 grams of borax in there just to help absorb any oxides, and whatever that putty stuff was, if there's any of that left over, I'll try and get that all into the slag so we end up with a real nice silver button at the bottom. So here's our little furnace setup. There's the propane bottle there, regulator that feeds this little burner. Just a single burner on this one. There's looking down the top, little vent hole. You can see silverware in there with the borax. And really that's it. That's all there is to it. It's sitting on some fire brick. Very cheap to make, very easy, works very well. Okay, it's been about 9 or 10 minutes now, and the silver is almost completely submerged under the borax there. The borax is starting to melt, and it's formed a little puddle on top. So we're going to let this heat up and get ready to pour here, probably another 5 or 10 minutes. So the whole process is going to only take about 15 minutes to melt this stuff down. It's really going pretty fast. Here's the cone mold we're using. It's something I built, just out of steel. Just comes down to a point. All the dense material will go to the bottom into the point there, and then all the slag will float on top, and you'll have a good separation between the metal and the slag. Okay, so here's our slag stuff on top from our silver pour. I'm going to knock it over into this bin. And right there is our silver button. Still pretty hot, but nice flat top. A little bit of slag I got to chip off there, but no big deal. Here's the slag, nice and glassy. All right, there's our scale, zeroed out in grams. Here's our sterling silver piece that we got from our pour. And wow, 300 grams. 300 grams of sterling silver. So out of 12 handles, that's 25 grams a handle. That's pretty cool. There's a lot of silver in those things. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. It was a fun one. How to get silver out of silverware. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.